times on my job, it was a shame.
Hallelujah.
I guess how many grandmas she got.
Hey, I was a liar.
Who?
I was a fornicator. I was an adulterer.
Good God.
Oh, good God
on my head. Ain't no sense in sitting up here lying my grandma.
Amen.
I had 4 or 5 grandmas and 5 or 6 grandpas.
I wasn't always the same. I wasn't always the same.
Who?
You know what I'm saying?
Well, I'm the only one to help.
I don't know. I remember when I was young. But I remember. You got to remember those little things. You understand? You got to remember.
Ain't nothing new.
Look.
Yes.
We thought we was getting over to on our parents.
Yes.
You understand? Oh, they old parents. They don't see me doing this here. Yeah. I know somebody sneak out all the time. And boy, I be trying to sneak back in. Somebody to lock the window. God, oh, somebody to lock the window. My God, doggone little sister. I said, they open up the window. And I know what time it is. I said, oh, I gotta go knock on the door. And you know when it's wrong.
Yeah.
Right, Mama?
Right.
You know when it's wrong. Yes. God ain't nowhere in it. Okay? You know when you do wrong.
Right.
I said, God, dog, how can I get in? I got to knock on the door. If I was coming to that door, Lord, you're gonna tear me up. Oh, mercy.
Okay, and he said, put away lying. Speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one to another. So we are married one to another.
Amen.
And we're under fire because we're not even truthful one to another.
No.
Husband and wives are breaking down, tearing down, because they're lying to each other. Amen. So the government's under fire because they're lying to each other. They're lying, they said they're lying to each other. They forgot the people weren't even existing. Amen. And look what he said, be angry. And sin not. Let not the sun go down on your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Let him that stole Bishop Aran steal
Amen.
No more.
Amen.
Amen. But let him labor, working with his hands, the things which is good, that he might have to give to him that need it. Let no him, this is the one right here that we all need to pay very close attention to. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Let me tell you something. You don't just, when you speak negativity, you're speaking your own life into existence.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna never be nothing. You a liar, you ain't gonna be nothing. Your dad ain't nothing, and your mama ain't nothing either. Amen. So you just spoke your child life into existence.
Come on,
amen.
Amen.
You got to say, I remember my ex told me, you ain't gonna never be able to hold up another man's jockstrap. And I went down to the gutter, I'm about to die. And then I remember, I didn't even know no word, but the Holy Spirit came to me and said, whose report shall you believe? Amen? Hallelujah.
Yes.
He said, he told me, the very first scripture he gave me, you are fiercely and wonderfully made. Hallelujah.
Now.
I said, I'm what? Yeah. I see, he said, you're fit. And I thought I was being conceited because I didn't know it was a scripture.
Mm-hmm.
God was talking to me even in my downward spiral. He said, you are more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. You can do all things. I looked upon all those scriptures that had me down in the dumps, and I began to say, you're more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me.
Man.
God, you said you knew me before I was formed in the belly of my... See, but if you don't know those scriptures, you can't speak to yourself.
Man.
So I pulled down the stronghold in my life.
Man.
I tore it down. I said, I'm more than a conqueror. Not only will I be able to hold up another man's jockstrap, I'll be able to hold up any man. I can be able to hold my own in Jesus' name. If no man don't ever come in my life, I'll... Look, I went living with me. I started with me. And this is why I'm hard and I'm trying to be firm and stern with the young people. Because there's too many young people going astray by their own mouth.
Yes.
You're hung by your own tongue.
Yes.
If you say you can't, then you won't.
Yes.
You got to know. I don't even care if it looks impossible.
Yes.
You got to know that you know that you... I told my grandson, he did it his way. Uh-huh. I said, when you make up your mind that you're going to do it, grandma and grandpa's way, because we telling you how to do it. That boy went down there, took his grandpa with him. The same thing we told him to do 8 months ago is what he did the other day. Went in there and passed that test. And he said, no, he said when he came out, thank you, Jesus. That's what he's with you in the beginning. Amen. Don't have to go through them brick walls.
Yes.
Stop going through the
walls.
You're going to go through your own Gethsemane. But not when you know that walls are... I told you that wall was brick.
Yes.
Yeah.
I said, Omari, it ain't going to work. Like, oh, I got to get one on it. All right, then. We sat back and said, Lord, let him be. And so all that time wasted.
Amen.
I'm dependent on God.
Yes.
Bishop, I'm consistent in my walk. I try to be consistent in what I say and consistent in what I do. Amen. Bishop.
I just want to piggyback.
Ooh, Lord.
Redeeming the time. This is what Pastor's talking about. Redeeming the time. Buy up those moments which others throw away. You know how we was just throwing time away. Yes. Oh, I'm going to be here forever. I'm going to stay young forever. We got to start buying up that time.
Right.
This is for everybody. Not just for the young, for the old, for the middle. It's for everyone. Amen?
Right.
And we have to improve every moment to wake up for those lost and sinners. We have to improve our moment, our speech, our conversation.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We got to improve. We got to let the word of God come out of our mouth.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We don't have to, you don't have to mention John this or Revelation this, but when you speak the word, you speak the principles of the word.
Amen.
You speak it in love.
Amen.
And guess what? The Holy Spirit will come upon you. Amen.
Amen.
And he will endow you with power. Amen. And it would overshadow the individual that you're talking to. Amen. So that they can receive.
Amen.
Because our whole idea is we're not here to push people away.
No.
You see, this is what we got to understand. We're here to draw to God.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Amen. This is my prayer. You know, when we pray, you know, y'all have to pray for us too.
Yes.
That we can be able to speak the word of God,
the
mysteries of Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So it can unlock those strongholds in our minds.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
That the enemy is trying to overtake us with. Let me tell you something. The world looks beautiful when you're in it.
Mm.
Sometimes we got to step out of it.
Yes.
You know? And this would help me. It helped me a lot. Even going to prison. God did not send me to prison.
Mm-hmm.
I sent me to prison.
Yeah.
By my thinking, by the decisions I was making, thinking I can be so cool or so smooth.
Yeah.
Have my grandson say, have the sauce.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? After going once or twice, I said, I got the sauce now. The third time, you know, I got the sauce. I know what to do now. I know who not to hang out with, but I still was out there.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. And I got saved when I was in prison. You know? And guess what? Guess what? Backsliding is real.
Yes, it is.
Amen.
Yes,
when they say backslide, that means what? You go back to where you were.
To go back.
Amen. Amen. And a lot of men and women in prison, a lot of them get saved. I ain't gonna lie. Generally, they get saved. But what happened? If you don't take Christ with you, you don't take the word with you when you go right back where you left off.
Amen.
I don't care. If you haven't conditioned your mind or made up your mind that you won't change and you're going to change the people, places, and things.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
You must do that. I remember when I got out, every time I got out, I went back to the same corner. I went back to the same partners, well, it was different ones. It was different because all of them, some had died, some had life in prison, you know. But the same thing, I went right back. So the last time I said, God, what must I do? He said, what must you do? So I had to make some decisions.
Yeah.
We all have to make decisions.
Right,
yes.
Amen, in our life to make a change. Now, it was uncomfortable. So I did something new this time. I did something different. I went to church. I went to the church. I didn't do that the first few times.
Lord.
You understand? I said, well, Lord, you speak about the strength is amongst the brethren. And that's where I went. I remember, I never forget, Brother O'Banion say, Brother Joe, the Lord told me to tell you to go to this church. You're going to find your wife.
Mm-hmm.
I said, wait a minute, Lord. Now I just prayed and talked to God. I said, look, I don't need nobody going to tell me who's going to be my wife. You understand? Or who's going to tell my wife who's going to be her husband? But he did not tell me that. Did y'all hear what I said? He said, the Lord told me to go to the church. I may find my wife. He that finds their wife, you heard what I'm saying? Finds a good thing. So I was looking for my good thing. Amen? And obtain favor. See, man, you don't even have to have no money. Well, when you got God's favor, amen. Everything you touch is going to prosper.
Yes.
Everything that you need and want, God will make sure that you have.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen. So we got to get away from that money. Let me tell you something. When you got God's favor and you walking uprightly before God, you walking circumspectly, you walking the word. Amen. You walking the word. The word saying walk upright. Upright. What that mean? You walk upright. Walk. Don't walk down like you used to walk. You walk upright in heart. You walk upright in spirit. You walk upright in your walk and in your talk. Cause I used to. Every 2-3 words to come out of my mouth was a cuss word. I've seen words. Amen. So I had to change my mouth, my talk.
Yeah.
Amen. I used to walk like this here. You know, I had to change that because it didn't associate with Christ.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? The way I used to dress, I dressed like I used to be. I was a hoodlum. Come on now. I was in the world. I was. You think somebody was worthy? I was worthy. I had handkerchief, I had earrings. Lord Jesus.
It looks good in the world.
It looked good in the world.
Amen.
It looked good. If I look in the mirror, well, I got the sauce, Lord Jesus. You understand? I got it. But once I got saved, good God Almighty, something changed. My thinking changed. See, you got to have an experience. Yes, that I met Christ. You got to meet him. You got to know that he is. And he's a rewarder of those that give him and seek him. So I'm seeking him every day. Amen. Because I know he's going to reward me. Matter of fact, he rewards me. Now look what he rewards. Love, Lord, a beautiful wife. Good God Almighty. I have to run from pillar to post. This one and that one. Amen. You understand? God has given you what you want and what you need.
Yes,
the scripture Psalm 23 says, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. So I let me know that he give me what I want too.
Right.
And he said, if I walk according to his word, that he will supply what? All my needs. According to his riches and glory. By Christ Jesus. Let me tell you something. This affair that we're in with God in Christ Jesus is real.
Hallelujah.
It's real. It's not a plaything. This thing with me is real. Because I know it's real. Because I can feel him all in my bones. I don't go by feeling. Okay? I don't go by emotion. But I feel him in me. I feel him there. Amen? And I thank God. And then he demonstrates it. In your life.
Yes.
He demonstrates. I haven't worked in almost a month right now. But let me tell you something. Every bill is being paid.
Yes.
Amen. How? By his grace. He said, in a time of need, I look at my, I said, Lord, I said, God, Lord, just give my grandson the grace that he needs to pass this test.
Yes.
He don't know that I was praying. I was praying because I know the forces. You understand? The forces of evil are always against us. You understand? Are always there to entice us to do contrary to what God is telling us to do. You understand? The enemy make it flamboyant.
Yes.
See, that what kept me. He made it look so spectacular. You know what I'm saying? So flashy. You know? And I thought we used to call it the game. So I say, no, this is the game. Yeah, I want part of the game. But then after some years, I say, good God Almighty, I'm getting old.
Hallelujah.
You know, I started out in the game when I was 11 years old.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't come to my right mind, total right mind, and surrender until I was 36 years old. Look at all the years. Amen. So right now I'm redeeming every time.
Hallelujah.
Every moment. Amen. You know, when I'm walking, when I'm not even with my wife. Amen. When I'm with other people, I'm walking upright. You understand? People got to see that.
Yes.
The youth got to see that.
Yes.
The saints got to see that. Yes. You understand? Yes, you can walk upright in
this
world.
Can.
Yes, you can. With Christ, we can do all things through him. We can do all things with God's help. And if we, look, if you're weak, he said, ask him what you need.
Yes.
He said, ask for that grace, that unmerited favor.
Amen.
He said, ask for his unmerited favor. What you need? Well, Lord, I need some patience. Lord, I need some understanding.
Yes.
Ask him. He will give it to you.
He will do it.
He will do it. So we're talking about walking circumspectly. We got to be consistent mm-hmm. in our walk. Yeah. We can't walk with the Lord today mm-hmm. and walk with the devil the next day.
No. Yes.
No. We can't play pity pat with Satan. Because one day you may get caught
Hallelujah.
Playing pity pat with Satan.
Amen.
And let me tell you the penalty
yes.
of Jesus.
You know, willing to pay that price.
It's heavy. Pastor, you have something?
Yeah, I just, in the midst of all of that, you know, I get also verse 31 is really, really a very heavy scripture. And one of the things I want to share, especially with the young people, the word of God says, Thy word, O Lord, have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. And that means that you study the word, and the word is inside of you. And it's something about, for me, I'm just going to go there. Modern technology is okay, but we've taken it to a whole nother level. We're taking it to the extreme. And it's okay to have the Bible on the phone, but there's nothing like getting in your word, hearing them pages turn, and hearing that word, putting that word in your spirit over and over and over, because that's God's divine design.
Yeah.
We can do things quick, but there ain't no quick fix in the Lord. That's the only thing. When you sit down with your word and spend time with God, because what happens in the word is you might get a scripture, and the footnote going to take you to another scripture, and the footnote going to take you to another scripture, and the footnote going to take you to another scripture, and it's that scripture that can radiate and transform your whole life. Amen? And so that's called studying the word. Not just reading the scripture. You got to study the word. He didn't say read the scripture. He didn't say read the book. He said study to show yourself approved unto God. And so that's what he said, not pastor. His word said to study. How do you study the word? You got to get this book. You got to take a conference. You got to concord it. You got to dictionary. And you got to find out what these new words mean. Because every word don't mean the same thing in every scripture. What was God saying? Who was he speaking to? What time was it? Amen? Amen. What time and place he was talking about? And so, as a young girl, that's what I did. I studied the word because I wanted to know him.
Mm-hmm.
So how bad do you want it? Mm-hmm. How bad do you want to make that change? Nobody can do that but you. And look at verse 31. It says, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Now, 32 is the one I was dealing with this morning with my grandson. I didn't even know we were going to go here this morning. He said, and be kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. If someone is kind to you, be kind to them. Amen. If someone is smiling, sometimes people are going through so much. I was telling my friends, if you're going through something, you're not the only one. You don't know what another person. I just had a little youngster on the verge of suicide for something that might not make sense to you, but it made heartaches for him. Amen. And so when someone's kind to you, be kind to them.
Yes.
And sometimes when you're going through, all somebody needs is a smile. Just with my husband laying hands on me just now, I said, babe, it's all right already. You know, because I told him last night, I said, I was honest with my feelings. I didn't act on my feelings, because if I acted on my feelings, brother, I'd have said, cancel this thing. But I didn't act. I told him how I felt. I said, I feel very despondent. I just feel miscommodulated. I feel weary. Amen. He said, what's wrong? I said, I don't know. I got bubbles in my stomach. You know what I'm saying? And so, not enough to quit, but enough to express to him how I feel so he can give me a word of encouragement.
Yes.
Amen. That's it. I have to change my own attitude, but he gave me a word of encouragement. Give me something to build on. I'm giving you something to build on. Ministers need help like everybody else. Amen. Because we pouring and we pouring and we pouring and we pouring. I got to drink too. I get thirsty too. We get thirsty like everybody else. Just like you need some water, I need some water. Amen? So this is what Bishop is talking about, that walk. That walk is so important. I really thank God for that prayer line, sister. You just don't have a clue. Amen? Now, that might not mean nothing to a whole lot of folk, but the prayer line, I'm telling you, when you hear the stories of people going through worse stuff something you're going through. And when you hear the stories of people going through what you're going through, you know, there's a word, there's a scripture, there's a voice crying out in the wilderness that gives you that hope. Hallelujah. I can make it one more day. Hallelujah. Because of what I heard, I can make it one more day. Hallelujah. And it's all, and guess what? That one more day is enough. Because it's one day at a time for each and every one.
Yes.
Bishop. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Did y'all get an understanding on being consistent in our walk?
Yes.
Amen. Because it's so much. And like I say, go back and read the whole chapter 5 of Ephesians. Amen. And also Colossians chapter 4. Let's go to Colossians chapter 4.
Are you getting something out of this?
Yes.
Now we're going to talk about being consistent in our talk, our conversation, and our speech.
Yes.
It's so important. Amen?
Because
it's two books over to your right. For the New Testament. Amen. And all right, it's two books over to the right. Amen.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank
Glory
you.
Be to God.
Amen.
I mean, this stuff is so good, y'all. I'm telling you.
It's rich.
I don't know about you, but it's delicious.
Amen.
Amen. It's rich. It's rich. It's rich.
Okay, now we're talking about our talk, our conversation, and our speech have to be consistent with the word. Okay?
Yes.
It's got to be consistent. Okay, Colossians chapter 4. Verse number 6. It say, let your speech be always with what? Grace. Seasoned
with salt.
That you may know how you ought to answer
every man.
See, your words got to be full of seasoning. You got to put some spice. You ever cook? You ever, who, how many cooks we got in here?
Yes.
I mean, you're not a cook.
No, I like to cook for the
every
now
and then. Every now and then? Okay, okay. How many have cooked beans before?
Hey.
Cooked some beans? Okay, okay. Don't you put some seasoning in them beans?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Huh? Don't you put some meat in them beans?
Oh, yeah.
Huh? You gotta put some onions, some neck bones. You understand? A little salt, a little pepper. Now, see, I'm from New Orleans. I put a little cayenne.
Yeah.
You know, if I say cayenne pepper. A little cayenne pepper. You know, just a little taste because everybody can't eat that spice.
Yes.
Amen. So you season. God wants our conversation to be seasoned.
Yes.
To be seasoned with the word.
Thank
Amen.
You.
So we got to take advantage of every opportunity in every situation.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like again, I keep putting emphasis. You don't have to say the chapter and verse, but you can speak the word.
Amen.
You can speak the principle.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you see someone, if you see a brother or sister, if you see someone lost that's overtaken, amen, you pray for God. God, give me the grace.
Right.
Give me the words to say to this individual.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, I've seen people, I've been in stores. I've been on a job, and people walk up to me, and we just start holding a conversation. And they begin to tell me their whole life stories or what they're going through. But see, at the same time, you got to be a good listener.
That's right.
Be ready to blah, 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 blah. Amen. Because sometimes God just wants you to just
take some information. That's right.
Amen? Because this individual is getting something off their shoulder.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Because pressure was a pipe. I ain't gonna lie. You know what I'm saying? Because all of us going through something.
Yes.
You know, at some point of time in our life.
Yes.
And sometimes we just need, well, it's so good when you got a husband and wife. It's real good because you can share with each other. Amen? And sometimes a woman don't share what she may have to share with a friend.
Amen.
You know, and same way with a man. He may have to share with a friend. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, well, I ain't saying your best friend. You're my best friend, baby. And I share everything with you, Lord.
Amen.
You know, but I'm just going by what I've heard through ministry. You know what I'm saying? I got to tell her everything. Only thing I don't tell my wife.
If he ain't got no money.
If I'm speaking to someone.
If he ain't got no money, you don't tell.
If I'm counseling someone, someone say, well, look, don't tell nobody.
You're right. Exactly.
Yes, exactly.
Company. You follow me? So I don't care how much I want to share when I know it's not going to go no further, by me giving my oath, my word to the individual.
That's it.
See, he said, well, look, I can trust him.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes.
Because people have told me things for years, I don't forget. I forgot, until I see that individual, and they may bring it up, but then I got to think about it. Remember, Bishop, when we sat down, I said, I won't lie, but I don't quite remember that. But, you know, being responsible, you know, and being faithful to your word, you know what I'm saying? It is so important, you know. And our speech, he said, let your speech be always spiced in season with answers, watch this here, that will oppose sin. You know, let our, you know, on a job, especially in the industry, you know, I'm around some roughnecks. And somebody always about to tell a nasty joke. I can tell when it's coming. I say, oh, here you go. I'm against the wall, nothing where I can go. I'm right there. I say, okay, God. Now, when I was a younger Christian, I used to handle it differently, you know. But I'm a little more mature, I say, okay. And sometimes I say, okay, now, it ain't nasty, huh, bro? Oh, no. And then he come out, I say, yes, it is. I say, well, I said, y'all need the Lord. I say, y'all need Jesus. You know, I say, y'all got to stop letting that devil use you, man. You know, I mean, you got to tell them. You know what I'm saying? I can't laugh. You know, I can't be partake of it. You know what I'm saying? You got to stand up. You got to, no.
That's right.
No. It's wrong.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Yes. And then when I try to tell me, oh, I'm going to get a Christian joke, I say, no, I won't hear no more.
Yes.
You know, so you have to let your conversation, because if you just go along with every wind that comes along, everything that comes along, you know, you're not distinguishing yourself. Right. You're not, you know, it's saying, hey, just like me. You know what I'm saying?
What separates you?
What separates us? Mm-hmm. So your conversation, I mean, you don't separate from the sinner because the sinner needs to see you out there.
Right. In other words, saying you got to be identified.
You got to be identified.
So when you take a stand, you have given your identity. Well, that's truly a man or woman of God. Not because you say you're a pastor preacher, because I know a whole bunch of them. I ain't the one. But it's your lifestyle. It's how you've taken a stand. It's how you carry or conducted yourself in the midst of a storm. Amen. Yes. That's a storm. And I hear people say it's hard to follow Christ. It's not.
No, it's simple, but
it's not easy. The reason why it's simple, because the word says what it means what it says. It's not easy because of the fact that you have to have a made up mind.
Yes.
You have to make a decision to be consistent in what God is saying to do.
Amen.
And once you start doing that, You got to see, we're talking about this, but we also gonna talk about the persecution in it. See, this is a simple walk. It's not easy because there's a lot of persecution that comes with walking upright before God. Amen.
Yeah.
And if you're a people person and you like to be pat on the back and you like that attention and you like this, that, and the other, it's gonna be some work for you. But you have to make up your mind.
Amen.
That it's in Christ that I live and Christ that I die.
Right.
And you got to make up your mind. We all walked in that behavior. We all did. None of us didn't, not one time. We even men may not have walked in it, but we walked with somebody that was in that behavior. And when you walk with them, you're just as guilty. I know many women in the treatment rooms didn't do no drugs, but their husband or the wife did. And a lot of them started using drugs because they wanted to please the man. Or some of them did the drugs because they wanted to please the woman. Amen? Well, then I'm going to do the drugs because I want to please Jesus. I'm going to take this pill right here. There's another pill called the God's pill. And that's the pill I designed to use.
Yes.
Do any pills you want. My pill is called the God's pill. Amen? And so that's a decision you have to make. Nobody can do it for you. It's an individual decision. Amen?
Well, see, that's why our conversation, it have to be upright. Because I remember when I was in the world, you know, I wanted to talk hip. I wanted to talk like everybody else.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted to leave an impression on somebody. Man, I was around no dog. You know, he ain't nothing like. But now the impression I want to leave in people's mind is the Lord.
Amen.
I wanted to be a Christian impression. I want it to be savory. I want it to be wholesome. Praise amen. God. I want to be an impression that's going to last through the test of time. Amen. Whenever I want to leave an impression that when they embark on in life or a situation, that impression come to mind and say, oh, not my impression, but the word of God, that brand that I put on their mind.
Yes.
Amen. From my speech, from my conversation, from my walk, from my action. Because let me tell you something, my mouth will say anything, but the power will come in your walk.
Yes.
The power will come in your relationship with God.
Yes.
The power will come in how you talk. Constantly, consistently.
Thank you.
Amen. You got to be consistent in your talk, your conversation, and your speech. It's no way out. You know what I'm saying? You can't be in today and out tomorrow.
No.
You know what I'm saying? It's a lifestyle. It's a way of life.
And it doesn't mean at some point you're not going to be firm and stern. Because there comes a time you got to be, say what you mean what you say, and you got to be firm and stern. Amen? And you got to be so, especially with our children. You know, you got, not only should they hear you be firm and stern, they got to see you be firm and stern. You can't, I remember some of the old folks when I was coming say, you don't do what I do, you do what I say. You know, that's double standards. But we did it. Knock you out. We did it. But that's not the right, that's not God's way. God's way says you do what the word say do. You act accordingly. Amen? And I like what Bishop said here. He said, When we talk with answers that will oppose sin and preserve from the corruption, things that we break, we tear down from people, let it be wise. Let us pull away something from them and then give them something. Amen.
Amen.
Give them something that they can hold on to.
Right.
Amen. Amen. Give them that hope. Amen. Tear them down. One thing, when I, as a substance abuse counselor, I never took away their dope and didn't give them no hope. And they said, well, how can you be a substance abuse counselor when you ain't never given no drugs? I said, because God sent me here for one thing. He sent me here to tear down the dope and give you the hope. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
He also showed me how to tell you and show you how to live life on life terms without sedating yourself. Amen. Because
yes.
The same problems you got, I got. The same bills you got, I probably got more than you. Amen.
Yes.
But I'm not going to shoot no dope, smoke no dope, hang with no dope, just because, I said, because to me, I don't get it. Because I'm watching everybody in this room. I ain't met nobody yet in my 32 years of counseling that can tell me that dope made them. I ain't never met nobody. You know, that's a downward spiral.
Yes.
Amen. So I'm here to push hope to you. Amen. And you couldn't say Jesus. I would say whom I choose to call Jesus Christ. Amen. You can say whatever you want. But I say his name is my higher power, whom I choose to call. Can't do nothing with that one. It's your choice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what sustains me. Amen. Glory to God. So that's the